Good morning, everyone. Pablo with BND. And first of all, I would like to thank everybody for the support I'm getting the channel. Just want to remind you guys, I still am running the giveaway for 10,000 subscribers. It's 5 gift certificates of $30 each, and depending on the revenue that we get by that point, I'll also be throwing away an Xbox One or a PS4, whatever the choice of the winner is. And for you to qualify, you only need to subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. And let's see what are we going to be looking at today. All right, today, Entitled Parents Beach Vacation. Well, let's start with the show. Entitled Mom tells me to move and to stop hoarding the sun. I honestly wish I was making this up. I was hoping to never have to post on this sub, only hear the stories. A little background. As I type this, I am enjoying my last day with my grandparents in Florida while in spring break. I'm from the north. I'm so pale. I match the sand at the beach. Yesterday, I went with my grandparents to the beach. And our story begins, and I decided that today, I'll go to the beach by myself. The beach wasn't busy, but it wasn't exactly empty either. This beach was quite popular due to it having free parking. I set my chair and cooler down, set up the chair, sit down, and begin scrolling Reddit. About 10-15 minutes go by, and I feel someone standing over me, then a tap on my shoulder. I turn around, time to meet the cast. EM, Entitled Mom, me, LH, lady's husband. And so we begin. Can I help you?
Yes, I was wondering if I could ask you to move so that we can sit here.
I'm sorry, but I was here first and I would rather not. There are plenty of other good spots on the beach though.
But I need this spot.
Why this specific spot?
Because it's close to the exit and I don't want to make my kids walk too far in the sand. Also, because this is where most of the sun is.
I look at her kids, a boy and his sister. They look maybe 12, 13. Both look like they just want to go play in the water already.
Your kids look fine. Why can't they handle a little walk? Just give me the spot.
Ma'am, I'm gonna be honest with you. I was here first. I am just relaxing and minding my own business. Also, there is almost an equal amount of sun this far down the beach. You can find another spot.
Stop hoarding the beach and the sun. This is a public beach and you don't own it or the sun. Move now, so me and my family can sit here.
Neither do you, which means I don't have to move. There's plenty of beach and more than enough sun for everyone.
Do you know who I am?
No, and I honestly don't care. At this point, lady's husband walks up to us.
Is everything okay here?
This little brat won't move and give us this spot. He's hoarding the beach and the sun for himself.
Lady's husband proceeds to look at his wife with a face that said, wow, I married this.
Honey, the kids and I have already set up the tent over there.
He points to a white tent with a chair set up under it. The kids are now in the water playing in the waves.
Why would you do that?
Because it was an open spot.
No! I wanted this spot! Move it all over here!
Lady's husband, trying to stay calm.
Dude needs a medal after this. Look, you could have been relaxing and spending time with our kids for about as long as you have been screaming at this man, who is minding his own business and enjoying the beach like everyone else here. Instead, you have been over here acting like a child and making a scene.
Entitled Mom and I are in shock.
The only time I agree with Entitled Mom this whole interaction.
Entitled Mom then stomps off towards the tent and lady's husband apologizes to me. They've been staying with his parents. Entitled Mom and lady's husband mom tend to argue a lot, so it put Entitled Mom in a bad mood. As a peace offering, lady's husband gave me a Pepsi from their cooler and we both went back to relaxing at the beach.
I don't care if he's disabled, it's our vacation.
Sorry for the format, I'm on mobile.
Context: my grandpa fought in Vietnam. and lost use of both his legs. It sounds cliche, but it's true. EM, entitled mom, ED, entitled dad, GP, grandpa, ME, mighty extra man. My brother got super good grades, so my mom took us all out to dinner. It was just me, my mom, my bro, and grandpa. Grandpa wanted to go to the bathroom, so I helped wheel him inside. The second I walked in, I smelled the worst smell I've ever smelled, and I'm not exaggerating. There was also a very not safe for work sounds coming from the disabled stall. My grandpa and me immediately knew what was happening. I wheeled grandpa up to the stall and knocked on it. This is the conversation that ensued.
Oh, hell!
Hurry up! You hear the move in a huge rush.
Excuse me, is this stall taken?
Yeah, man! Use the next one!
Sorry, but my grandpa's wheelchair won't fit in the other stalls.
Then entitled dad opens the door and they both walk out.
Why can't you New Yorkers just let us have some fun?
Excuse me?
We're from Atlanta! This is our vacation away from our kids.
That doesn't excuse you from committing a crime.
Do you know how much money, time, and effort we put in our kids? We deserve a break.
This is a restaurant, not your house. If you're gonna have sex, do it in the hotel room.
Now, entitled mom just goes ballistic, while entitled dad goes silent.
We have three kids and work my ass off every day. All you do is sit in a freaking wheelchair all day, you freaking cripple.
Now, grandpa starts talking about the horrible stuff he saw in Vietnam, which really surprised me, because he has PTSD. But in summary, just imagine the Vietnam scene from Forrest Gump.
Oh, screw off, you skinny red bastard.
Then entitled mom grabs her husband's hand and they both run out. Because the restaurant we were eating at was their hotel's restaurant, the authorities were able to find them pretty quickly. I don't know what happened to them, but I hope they're in jail. I've read stories like this in this subreddit, but I'd never think it would happen to me. A couple of tourist parents were having sex in the bathroom and verbally insulted my disabled gramps. Edit. Thank you everyone for the support. It was the dumbest situation I've ever been. My friend's tits are offensive to entitled mom. So, basic information. Me and my best friends were in the beach, just chilling. One thing I need to inform is that my best friend is on the big-breasted side of the spectrum. So, like any big-breasted woman, bikinis are a nightmare to her. She always stared at, and that makes her really uncomfortable. Now to the story. Me and her were in a more secluded part of the beach. We had swam and we decided to sit a bit. When we came back to our chairs, a family was settled down near us. The mom was in her late 30s and the dad was in his early 50s. They had a child with them, 9-ish-year-old boy. We didn't pay mind to them. We just sit in our chairs and talk for a bit. I noticed the dad of the family looking at my friend but paid no mind. I decided to pick something to drink. There was a bar nearby. I asked my friend if she wanted something. She asked me for a lemonade. I go to the bar and see the entitled mom coming near me. I waited in the line until entitled mom comes to talk to me. EM, entitled mother, me, a unicorn.
Hi. I saw that you and your friend are nearby me and my family.
I just nodded to her.
I think your friend is really beautiful, but she's showing too much cleavage.
I look at her, trying to think what to respond to this.
Well, she can't be faulted for being born with big breasts, can her?
She looked at me like she was expecting me to agree with her.
Well, she could not use a bikini that small.
Said with somewhat annoyed voice.
She can do whatever she wants, lady.
She became red at that. I don't think that this woman has ever heard someone disagree with her before.
She's looking like a slut. My child will be traumatized.
I looked back where my friend was sitting.
have a clear view of her and the entitled mom's family. Her child is doing sandcastles. A cute view, I might add. And her husband staring hard at my friend, who is passing sunscreen at the time. So the problem was not her child, it was her husband. Well, I can't do much, lady. Now please leave me alone. Finally, it was my turn, so I picked my drinks and ignored the entitled mom. She wasn't happy about it, though.
Don't you dare ignore me, young man. I'm not finished.
I just looked at her and took a sip of my drink before saying, lady, your kid isn't even looking at my friend. Your husband, on the other hand, I pointed at her husband who was staring at my friend with hungry eyes. She looked shocked and just starting to walk to her husband. I go to my friend, gave her her drink and sit beside her, watching the wife furious whisper at her husband. Not long after, my friend and I decided to leave. I didn't tell my friend about the crazy lady. She has confidence issues enough. At least, I didn't see this family ever again. Entitled mom wants scarred veteran off a public beach. Background stuff. So this happened about 3 months ago when me, my mom, and her brother, my uncle, who is a veteran which spent time fighting the Gulf War in the Falklands, picking up some nasty burn and bullet scars, went to Hunston Beach in Norfolk, England. We're relaxing on some rocks at a rock pool area when my uncle, who had his shirt off the whole entire time, his scars full view, is approached by an entitled mother and her daughter. Here's how it went down.
Excuse me, young man. Can you go somewhere else?
I'm sorry, what?
I want you to go somewhere else. That man you're with is upsetting my daughter.
Her daughter has run over to some other children a little bit away, playing the rock pool.
She doesn't seem very upset, pointing over to her. Now, apparently, that was some kind of soul-shattering insult to her, because she freaking exploded, screaming things like, you don't know my daughter! Get the freaking freak off this beach!
My uncle, who up to now heard none of this, turns his head and begins marching up to her.
What did you just call me? In a calm yet threatening tone,
entitled mom clearly misjudged the size of him from far away.
You disgusting man! Either cover your scars or go somewhere else.
By now, the beachgoers have stopped what they're doing and either began watching it disunfold or tried to get her to stop screaming and swearing near the children.
Listen, lady. I'm trying to enjoy my day. If you don't like my scars, which I got fighting for my country, you leave. This is a public beach, and I'm allowed to be here.
She tries to get a local bobby, policeman, to get him off the beach, which he tells her my uncle can't stay. This drives her to say that she saw him doing drugs in front of the public. Now me, my mom, my uncle, and all the onlookers are pissed and quickly prove her wrong. And she's placed under arrest for false accusations. We go back to relax and the daughter's dad, who wasn't seen for this entire exchange, took her home. Then, we got ice cream.
Hey guys, that's it for today and thank you very much if you got to the end of this video. Don't forget to subscribe, leave me a like and a comment. And I'll be seeing you guys Wednesday for more stories and Friday for a veteran point of view. I just want to say you guys have been great. Love the comments. I try to answer to all I can. Well, the truth is I answer to all the comments I get. And, well, that's it. I'm just really, really excited lately with how things have been turned out with the changes I made to the channel. And I hope you guys have a great week. Enjoy. Have a great Monday. Have a great end of the week, and don't forget, make your lives extraordinary. Take care and have a great day.